Hi everybody, hope you're all right. Back out enjoying the sunshine again. So I just thought I'd do another little short video, just a little bit of maybe like a sort of mobility one that you could just do for 5 or 10 minutes in the morning or whenever. There is a little bit of, I suppose, what you might call yoga in it, but it's only very gentle, and at the end of the day your body doesn't really mind whether it's doing yoga or Pilates or whatever, as long as you're moving really. So just a little bit of a short one to get things moving. As always, if you haven't done classes with me before or you've got any issues or problems, please be careful, please be mindful. If anything doesn't feel great, then it probably isn't great, and just get in touch and we can give you alternatives, different ways of doing things. This one will involve quite a bit of sort of on your knees, hands and knees, so if your knees aren't too happy you can always pad them up with cushions, or if that still doesn't work maybe choose something different. My doggies have come to join me. It's too nice to put them inside, so I hope they're going to behave. I think Nip's just out of shop, but Diesel's wandered in. They've had a lovely long walk this morning, so they should just go to sleep. We shall see. Okay, so as I said, we're going to start on hands and knees. We'll have wrists under shoulders, knees under hips, and feet just nice and relaxed behind you. We just start with cat, so we're going to breathe out. Tuck the tailbone, round the back up towards the ceiling. Pause here and have a nice deep breath in. And breathe out, lift the tailbone. And just lengthen back to neutral. So breathing out, rounding the back up. Holding for a deep breath in into the back and the sides of the rib cage. And breathing out, just to lengthen back to neutral. So nice and slow. Just noticing how that feels, giving yourself plenty of time to get the lower back, then the middle, and then the upper back moving. Nice deep breath in to the back of the body at the top there, and breathe out to lengthen back again. Let's go for two more like that. Breathing out to round up, holding for a deep breath in, breathing out, lengthen back to neutral. We're just going to do a few scapular isolations, so keeping the back relatively, or the backbone relatively straight, we're just going to let the chest sink towards the mat and then float back up again. So we'll breathe out as we sink down and breathe in as we float back up again, and just letting those shoulder blades slide towards each other as you sink down, gently pushing them apart as you come back up. And just notice how that feels, moving nice and slowly. Go for two more. Breathing out to sink down. Breathing in to float up. Last one. Okay, so we're going to do some thread the needle. Now, if you want to, you can take one leg out to the side. And then we're going to take the arm on that side, thread it under the other one. And come back through and open up. So we'll breathe out to reach under, and we'll breathe in to come back through. We're just getting a nice twist through the body. Having your leg out to the side is totally optional. You can keep that knee just where it was. Let's go one more this way. Center. Bring that leg back in, take the other one out if you want to. Breathing out, reach under. Breathing in and open up. And just notice how it feels in this direction compared to the other. And just check your hips are staying up above your knees. We'll go for one more. And come back through. And let that hand come down, let the leg come back. So I'm going to take my knees a bit wider, totally optional. If you take your knees wider, you're going to get more of a stretch into the hips. I'm just going to sink the tailbone back to the heels, come into a nice shell stretch. And just breathe into the back of your body again. You can just start to let your weight come across to one side and then to the other. Just moving your chest gently one way, across towards one leg, and then towards the other one. Just staying nice and low, should feel quite nice. A little bit of mobilization through the hips, through the back. And then come back to the centre. We're going to walk the hands across to one side. Just find that nice stretch through the long side of the body. Breathe into that long side of the rib cage. So if you want to increase the stretch a little bit, cross the one hand over the other. Try and keep the shoulders parallel to the floor. Needles on the move. And then we'll walk those hands across to the other side. Find the stretch into the long side of the body again. Breathe into that. And if you want to, cross that one hand over the other to increase the stretch a bit more. Just keep breathing into the long side of the body. And come back to the centre. So come back up onto those hands and knees. So this is where we're going to go a little bit yoga-ish, if you like. So tuck the toes, keep the knees as bent as you need to. Try and take those hips up towards the sky and let the shoulders come back towards the knees. And then just gently pedaling out through the back of the legs. So just finding that stretch down through the back of one leg and then the other. Just let the shoulders draw away from your ears. Keep that feeling of lift through your tummy. Think about your seat bones flaring up towards the sky or the ceiling. And then we'll let both heels come down. And we're going to step one foot forward in between the hands. And let the back knee come down. So that in itself might be quite a stretch for you. So if you need to bring the back knee a bit closer into the front one, that will reduce the stretch a little bit. So from here, you're going to keep the one hand on the floor by your foot and take the other hand up towards the sky. So you're just twisting towards that front leg. Have a couple of breaths there. Let that hand come back and bring it inside that other foot. Take the other hand up towards the sky. So we'll just do a couple more of those each way. Twisting towards your bent leg. And then twisting away from the bent leg. I'm going to breathe in as I open up and breathe out to come back to the middle. Okay, tuck those back toes under, step that foot back, come back into your down dog position, little pedal out through the back of those legs again. Heels come down and step the other foot forward. Let that back knee come down. So again, keep the one hand on the floor. Breathe in and open up, twist towards that bent leg. Breathing out to come down. Bring that hand inside the foot. Breathe in to open. Breathe out to come back down. A couple more each way. One. Bring those hands back to the either side of the foot. Get that foot back. Come back up into your down dog. Have a little pedal out through the back of those legs. Okay, step step the other foot forwards again. Let that knee come down. So a bit of a stronger stretch now. Keep the hands on the floor and just see if you can straighten out through that back leg. You might feel your glutes working a little bit. Might get a bit of a stretch through the front of that hip. And then gently let that knee come back down. And again. Just breathing out to straighten. I feel those glutes working, breathing in to come back down. So try and keep your bottom nice and low. Temptation will be to come up, see if you can stay the same position as when your knee's on the floor and just push the heel backwards to straighten that leg. Let's go for a couple more. Hold this one. Now you might just stay here. If you know your back's quite happy and your balance is good, take those hands up. Nice deep breath in and let them come back down to the mat. That feels nice. We'll do a couple more. And okay, step that foot back. Little pedal out through the back of the legs again. And then let those heels come down. Step the other foot forwards. Let that knee come down for a moment. Check your comfy and balance. And then just pushing that back leg straight and then letting the knee come down. So you can see this side I'm a bit tighter. My bum wants to come up towards the sky a little bit more, so I'm going to try and keep that lower. Just push back through the heel. Feel that leg straight and feel those glutes working a little bit. Just check those shoulders are still drawing away from your ears. Crown of the head gently reaching forwards. Go for a couple more. We'll hold the next one. Balance is not so good this way, so we'll see what happens. Gently coming up. Let those arms come around. Back to the mat. So as long as that feels good, go again. Okay, step that foot back. Come into your nice down dog. Just have another little pedal out through the back of those legs once again. And then we'll let those knees come down, let the feet flatten, and just drop back into your shell stretch. And a couple of nice deep breaths into the back of the body again. And then walk those hands back up. So if you're comfortable in kneeling, stay in kneeling. And turn so you can see me, or come and sit with your legs crossed. So, nice deep breath in and reach up, and then breathe out and just twist to one side. Hand behind you helps you sit up really nice and tall. Hand in front helps you to twist a little bit. Breathe in, grow a bit taller, and breathe out and maybe twist a little bit more. Gently release to the middle, have a nice breath in and reach up, and breathe out, twist the other way. And gently release back to the middle. So just to make your way up to stand, tuck those toes under, roll back over the feet so you can keep the hands on the mat. Take the hips up towards the sky, maybe step those feet so they're just hip width apart. And then when you're ready, bend the knees, drop the tailbone and unroll back up to stand. You'll probably come just out of shot, there we go. So I hope you enjoyed that, a little bit different. Obviously I'm not a yoga teacher, but I just enjoy that little bit of movement. Hopefully it feels nice for you as well. Alright, take care, bye bye.